first of all, understand the concept. What is simple finance? Most of the people are saying S4, they are using the word, they are using some S financials. Like this, they are going to use different types of words. So, but a simple finance is an add-in on ERP. This is not the new concept. So here, the point is, already we have ECC 6, EHP 7 with the HANA database. So you need to add this simple finance apps in your system. A standard product development to work on the top of the ERP. The official name is SAP Simple Finance Add-on 2.0 for SAP Business Suite powered by accounting. So the product name is SAP S Financials. So if you say SAP S Financials, then it is called Simple Finance Apps. And so this is normally introduced in March 2015 into the market. And it includes accounting and also other activities such as cash management and integrated business planning, that is called including BPC, and the finance and additional innovations such as area of treasury and risk management, and the collaborative financial operations such as FSCM, such as credit management, collections, disputes, and FI and CO. That means what I am saying is, what are the major changes occurred in simple finance? With the compare with the traditional financial system, this we need to understand very clearly. And so here the point is, you need to concentrate on FI, CO, FSCM, that means which includes credit collections disputes, and also treasury and risk management and cash and liquidity. So these things are highly integrated in migration of data. So before implementing a simple finance, what things you need to take into consideration? So here the major important functionalities, as we discussed, the simple finance replaces the classical financial applications. So so normally in accounting, the SAP enhancement pack 7 for ECC 6.0. So this everybody know, because ECC 6 EHP 7 means nowadays available in the market. The Simple Finance add-on for the SAP Business Suite powered by HANA comes with simplified data models. So the total tables, so if you see in the internal part of Simple Finance apps, the total tables and applications index tables that have been removed and replaced with HANA views. So with the same technical names, that means here there is called this transaction process is known as data redundancy. The redundancy is not required in simple finance apps, and this means the impact needs to access on our interface your data warehouse, your authorization profiles, and potential your monitoring tooling. Some industry solutions SAP ERP is not fully available. So but we need to check the asset accounting and also other compatible accessories, so that means add-ons, so in the system landscape. So the user experience like to change, so access the impact on required skill set in your team. That means here not only one person is going to handle the simple finance apps, so you need to integrate all the people into one step, and the potential need to rewrite the documentation and the training materials. So here, handling the required SP levels, so for SAP ERP 6.0, E11, and SAP NetWeaver, that means we need to integrate different types of servers here. One is SAP ERP 6.0 EHP 7, which runs in HANA tool, and SAP NetWeaver 7.40. With utmost, we need to integrate with data warehouse. That means three servers has been integrated here. Before you install the simple finance add-in, you must prepare the migration of application data. Then what is migration? So migration means in each and every step of functional asset, so we need to integrate the data. That means, say for example, if your company is using ECC 6 and EHP 7, or ECC 6 or EHP version, any version. So now your company want to implement simple finance apps. So we need to connect the link between, that means we need to migrate the tables between existing ERP system and also the HANA system. This process is known as the migration. So these steps require the financial application knowledge. So if you want to update this, So you require financial application knowledge is mandatory. So without a financial application knowledge, you can't do anything in Simple Finance. So now the first point is install the finance add-in software and update manager. Ensure that you have developed the latest version of SAP Service Market. You need to take this new edition and SAP HANA Live package using HANA Lifecycle Management. And to run the finance application, you must migrate the application data first for SPS 0.2 and SPS 0.3. So then SPS 0.4. So these things are required. And you can nowadays SP9 is also available. So you instead of 02, 03, 04, you can directly migrate with SP09. So some additional configuration is required. For more information, you can see the migration to SAP Simple Finance apps that we are going to discuss later. So first of all, you need to understand the architecture, then only you can understand the migration. So here the main important functionalities to run the Simple Finance is the system should be in S4 HANA database and ECC6 EHP 7 with SR2 on HANA, and Fury and UI5 is need to be get updated, and data warehousing servers need to integrate. SAP HANA SP9 and BPC10 is required. So these, if you integrate all these things, then you can see the Simple Finance apps in your system. Migration to SAP accounting. So what things in the migrate and why it is migrated? You need to migrate from SAP ERP financials to SAP accounting powered by HANA because the data models of financial accounting and controlling data has been changed. Before going to do this, first let's see the application activity. So what things you need to migrate? So you can see in my screen here, the concept is integrated like this: S4 HANA with ECC6 and EHP7 with SR2 on HANA database. This is mandatory, and Fury and UI5 is required. So to update the cloud reporting, data warehousing service for migration purpose, and SAP HANA SP9 and BPC10. So these, if you combine all these servers into one place, then the complete picture has been designed. And once it is integrated, you can see like this. See, make sure that the UI web client has been updated or not from the technical assets. Then you can see the Simple Finance add-in of SAP Business Suite. So this is required. So this is especially used for migration of data, as we discussed in the previous step. So most of the functional consultant, we need to understand what is migration and what data need to migrate and from where the data need to collect and what tables we need to integrate. So here, no need to concentrate on technical assets, but we need to concentrate more on functional assets. Okay. So here, if you see, there are a lot of things are there. So what data we need to migrate, from where the migration will come. So all these things come into picture. So later we are going to discuss all these points. So before that, I want to explain you what is migration and how it the accounting data has been integrated with SAP HANA database. The total tables and application index tables of general ledger accounting, normally we know very well. As a finance people, we know very well. So there is a different types of tables are there. The total tables and application tables of accounts receivables and accounts payables, because the general ledger accounts receivables and accounts payable is a major part from finance assets. The total tables of controlling and replacing these tables, that means these tables are already available in SAP. These tables are replacing with views the same names, ensure that the continuation of all read necessary to table maintenance. So that means we are taking the existing tables only, but we are migrating. The FSEO documents are linked to one another at item level SAP accounting powered by HANA. Simple example, when you post a transaction in customer data, so automatically whenever the invoice is generated and once the down payment and partial payment has been updated, automatically you can see this is migrated to general ledger. That means the same will be reflected in GL also. This makes comparison drilled out report across areas possibility for both application areas. And the most important functionality is we need to concentrate on reporting tools also. Then, see, in this picture, you can see for the existing data and simple finance apps. So if you see the point of SAP ERP financial in classical database, so data redundancy, that means duplication of data, effort involved in reconciliation. So that means we need to involve most of the effort. We need to keep our complete effort in reconciliation of data. So the flexibility is also very less. But if you come to new enhancement of smart finance or simple finance, higher data through output and less reconciliation, no need to concentrate on reconciliation because whenever you post a transaction, automatically it is reconciling. Greater flexibility, reduced data volume. Here, the data volume is also very important. Based on the data volume, the speed will increase. Better performance. So all these things we need to compare practically while we are understanding the concepts. So there are two approaches are there to learn simple finance. One is migration and without migration also. So if your company is going to migrate from existing ERP system to new ERP, new simple finance ERP system, the migration is mandatory. But if you are going to use without ERP system, so if you want to update the financial applications with the new ERP system with S4 updates, so in that case it's not required. But table migration is required. Then what are the major focus in simple finance? There are three major factors are there. While we are learning simple finance apps, we need to concentrate on HANA. That means HANA means S4 updates. You need to understand the basics of HANA and S4 structure, because we are integrating the table. As a functional consultant also, we need to understand the tables. Then the second part is finance apps, where the major changes occurred in finance apps, even in FICO, FSCM, treasury and risk management, and cash and liquidity. So these things we need to concentrate. So if you know only FICO, there is no use. So that is the reason you need to understand in different levels. FICO, voting per mandatory, FSCM, which includes credit, collections, dispute, these three things, and treasury and risk management to integrate the bank data to cash management, and also cash management. So all these things we need to concentrate on finance apps. And if you come to reports, so you need to understand what is Fury and also how it is integrated with the simple finance apps and Luminar. So Luminar is also one of the internal tool which is used to structureize the graphical reports. So these three major parts we need to understand. Number one, basic of HANA. Number two, finance. The major concentration is FICO, FSCM, and TRM, cash and liquidity. And if you come to the reporting tools, Fury and Luminar, then this is a complete package of so simple finance apps. Then, so now we are going to discuss. There are two ways we need to understand. One is from the technical point, what is the main difference between traditional approach, that means the traditional database, and also this S4 HANA database. And in the functional aspect also, we need to understand. So here, the major changes in between the traditional financial system and simple finance in technical approach. First, I'm going to concentrate on technical approach. So the traditional DBMS, so database management system, which are designed for optimization, performance on hardware with constant main memory. That means, so in traditional database system, this is the everything is completely depend on main memory. So if you compare with HANA database, SAP HANA S4 database is designed from the ground. The idea, the memory is available in evidency to keep all the data such as input and output. Access to hard disk is not constant. That means The pressure is very less. And the traditional database system put most effort in to optimize hard disk. That means it's completely dependent on hard disk. So SAP HANA S4 focus on optimization memory access between CPU, cache and main memory. And if you come to the third point, the traditional database could not keep with the user's expectation in sight of billions and of data entries. So that at the point of redundancy, the data consistency increased the data storage and increased more complex issues. So, but in SAP HANA, S4 improves performance radically as outlined in the nature in the need for redundancy vanish. That means the redundancy is completely vanished based on the single source data delivered can be calculated on the fly instead of they being physically stored in the database. Hence, the result simplification method is called removal of redundancy. That means this is nothing but every data has been updated in the cloud. So the storage level is required is very less compared with the traditional traditional database. And whenever the storage capacity is low, that means required less space, the system will fast. Then if you come to functional approach, this we can easily understand. Everyone can easily understand. The major changes in between the traditional financial system and simple financial system in functional approach. In traditional database, there is the line items in a financial accounting. We refer the to old tables. That means, as I already told you, there is some tables are there. For comparison, this merges the data structure neither to separate components. The fundamental and essential data triple of every financial accounting so system beside the master data and accounting documents. That means it will increase the time interval so to post the transaction. So a simple finance system of all materializations has been removed in order to avoid. That means here there is no redundancy. So whenever there is no redundancy, automatically the possibility of increasing the materialization is very easy. Instead of corresponding table have been replaced with compactable view. So here in traditional financial system, we have horizontal view. But in new financial system, that means in HANA database, so this is compactable view. And the system records each transaction as an accounting document with last two line items for each call, debit and credit. So here another important point is everybody know this. Even if you use traditional system or HANA system, so each transaction we require debit and credit. And one more important functionality in new financial, new HANA database. Any derived data can be calculated on the fly. Fly means cloud. Most times with higher performance than the traditional disk-based system. Then, so here, if you see, the millions of billions of accounting documents are stored all header data in the table, and the stores line items in the separate table and slow down the disk performance. So, and one more important point is SAP ERP financial system need materialization. View and materialization aggregates in order to process sufficient fast access to line items with specified properties or aggregate values. This method is not available in traditional battle system. So you can see a small example here which I had specified. There are 500 accounting documents you want to post, and each transaction consists of 6 line items, means 26,000 times affected by update type, insert, delete, all these operations. So the time spent to post a single document is 200 minutes per second. But in simple finance, redundancy is completely removed. So duplication, that means duplication is completely. So this is based on the migration we are going to update. So but simple finance only needs to insert 11,000 data times into the tables. So posting that time requires 100 minutes per second for end to end. So that means if you see the major changes, so from where the migrating is done, simple finance add in business suite. Here you can see clearly preparations of migration of customization. So first, before going to customize anything, first we need to migrate the data. What customization? That means what migrations we need to consider. Number one, general ledger. Preparation of migration of customization for the general ledger. So that means we are migrating. So the reference IMG for financial accounting. Based on that, we are migrated. Asset accounting and controlling. So even in controlling also major concepts has been changed. That is COPA. So operating concern. These things are completely changed. Once if you understand how to migrate this data, so then what we need to do is we need to update this migrations. Migration of cost elements and customizations. Migration of data, line items to new data structure. Migration of balances. So complete migration. Activities after migration. So finally what we need to do is once these migration activities has been done, we need to test the system. That means we require some data from FI, CO, and other activities from FSCM also. Then we need to test. So whether the data has been completely migrated or not. After seeing the data comparison also, then we need to run the reports. Okay. So whenever you run the reports, you can easily understand where the migration has happened and what is the resultant of migration. And the most important factor is, if you are using a new system for these concepts, you need to activate some business functionalities. That also you need to update. And nowadays, most of the people has FSEO knowledge and they want to learn simple finance apps. So I'm strictly recommending, even if you have a FSCM functionalities with cash management applications, then the simple finance concept is very easy to understand. Okay. And here, what we are going to do is, we are going to concentrate on Luminar as well as Fury. So Luminar is especially used for reporting and so graphical reporting. And Fury is especially used to update the cloud reporting. So these are the concepts which I am going to discuss. That means in my training, I had divided the concept into three categories. One is HENA concepts with S4. So that we are going to discuss for first 15 sessions. And 15 sessions means 2 hours a session each. That means total 30 sessions. And once it is clear, then we are going to concentrate on FSEO and FSCM migration. And then we are going to see the changes occurred in simple finance accounting. So for this, I require total 15 sessions. That means total 30 sessions. Each session is for 2 hours. And reportings, how you need to upload these reports in Luminar as well as Fury. So for that, I required another 30 sessions. That means 15 sessions is required. So total 45 sessions. Each session is for 2 hours. We are going to concentrate on these applications. That means these three levels we are going to concentrate. Okay. And regarding to other details, you can directly contact and you can get directly get the picture. So, and my recommendation is, before going to attend the training, so please refer the HENA concepts if there anything is available from your end, so that there is a chance to ask the questions. And the materials which I'm going to provide, so I'm going to provide the direct material to you to your Gmail ID. And so we are concentrating on two steps. One is migration and without migration. Both that materials I'm going to forward it to you. And then some interview questions. So that means not the interview questions, the most common questions you can say, which is comes from simple finance apps. So that also we are going to discuss. And some body applications, wherever it is required, we are going to discuss. That means simply say that the technical aspects and functional aspects, both we are going to concentrate. Okay. So, okay. Thank you. And if you have any queries, you can directly contact me and you can ask me. Thank you. Thank you very much.